Greetings, Devans. Here I am reading another mail, and this mails I am reading very selectively. I am not reading all the mails that I get, but few of these mails that I am reading, because this is the state of the work that I am involved into, and the kind of conveying that we are doing through this platform is to, for one, to touch these kind of realms. It's more very deep. And the reason I read this is I am happy to see that it is touching that zone, that corner of you which it is intended to touch. So that is ensuring that, you know, things are moving in the right direction. And this is also for the others who have similar interests. As I told you, not everybody will have interest into all these very deep details. Very few can actually even soar and touch that space which is very, very deep within us. Why we are not able to touch it? Because we have other interests still lurking within us. So many worldliness, so many things of materialism, and so many desires that are outward. That is one reason we cannot get inward. And these are all the spaces that we are touching inward. And I've been talking a lot about the past 1 month about Bhagwan Ramana's work, Bhagwan Nityananda's work, Bhagwan Nisargadatta Maharaj's work. These are all those spaces, those deep spaces within you which you can touch. And once you touch those spaces, the doership will start ending. You know, it's all in the doing. There's been so much of doing and doing and do this and do that and do this and do that. It's never ending. Until I'm glad, until I wouldn't have realized that, until I would have come across Advaita Vedantas and some of the great masters who are enlightened beings in this Advaita Vedanta, who are teaching so much about the Atma Bodha. And the grace of our masters and the lineage makes it possible for us to tap into those zones for those people who are wanting to. You know, you will need to have that entire intense seeking, intense desire, the higher desire towards the mumukshatva, towards being a mumuksha. Mumuksha is an intense seeker of liberation. So only when you have that zone where you have pulled your string to such an extent that, you know, there's nothing beyond it. You come to a stage, you reach to a stage where there is nothing else to lose. Such people are dangerous people. They have nothing left to lose. Only those who have something to lose will cling on. Otherwise, they have nothing to lose. And you know, I, as per my experience, it says that you got to reach that space where there is nothing to lose, then there is nothing to fear. Fear comes from if there is something to lose. So if there is nothing to lose, you are going beyond into that deep space where many truths will be just unraveled to you. It will be revealed to you. So let me read this. And I found this very relating to whatever tattva we are talking about. It says, Bhaiya, I hear Nityananda's guidance in your voice at exact situation. This is something I present to with His grace shining through this, in bracket, it is put as my mind. It's very poetic language, but you know, it can come only in an ecstatic state. Correct me if I'm wrong, please. It's the mind which always, this is what I want to emphasize on, okay? This happens to all of us. It's the mind which always needs something or some story to cling to, gore its existence and then grow gigantically to consume and pervade the self. So true. So if you're identifying this, I believe only in certain states of awareness, these glimpses will come to you that it's the mind that is doing all this stuff. It's the mind that always needs some or the other thing or some or the other story to cling on to so that it can prove its existence and thus grow gigantically. It will just grow. All that drama will grow in the mind to consume and pervade the self. So this is what distracts us from that moving towards what we call as self-realization. The play of the mind, the distractions, the dramas we are caught up in. So that is what I am saying. If you get into that mind and then become again a doer and try to do something to get there, which you are already there. Tattvamasi is a situation that is explained, that you already are in that situation. There is some cloud that you are clouded with, and they are passing clouds. Again, you don't have to even push the clouds. You just have to stay a witness to that cloud while it is passing. So while it is passing, it sounds very dramatic. It makes you react. It makes you get into the play. That feeling that this cloud, oh, this cloud has come, let me. But if you just stay still there, this too shall pass. It will pass. And when you pass, you see the sun, as simple as that. So this is what even the Advaita Vedanta, today morning I put a clip from Advaita Vedanta, which is talking, Tattvamasi, thou art that, you are already that. But the clouds which are moving puts you into the drama of doership. Let me do this and let me get the cloud clear. Let me vanish the cloud, which is anyhow a cloud. See, if you try to destroy the cloud, you can't destroy the cloud. Cloud look very thick, and you when you go into the cloud, you see when the aeroplane goes into the cloud, it just dissipates. There is nothing. It's just air. It's not a substance at all. It just moves apart. But from outside, it looks very thick. This is what happens when we look at the clouds in our mind, which is happening. So if there is impatience and if there is a lot of doership which comes from the ego consciousness, I got to destroy this. So I get up to destroy my ego, destroy my anger, destroy my lust and so and so. It's a very fancy term and it gives good valor and pride that I am going to now kill this so that I get relieved and I attain that which I am looking forward to, but because this has become the obstacle, I need to destroy this obstacle. Advaita Vedanta says the other way. It says it's a foolish act to get foolish and get involved in that which is again Maya. Advaita Vedanta says, when once you identify this as Maya, which is illusory, which is just playing its role out there, you need not again put up your sleeves and get into that muck. Rather, you put a back seat and just observe things as it passes, as a lot of things. But yes, that comes from your stability. That ability to pull back and stay stable comes from your stability. That needs strength. That is understood. So you need to strengthen up that. All the act that we are doing is to strengthen up, to bring yourself into that stability that you can remain stable and still while this is happening. That needs work. And that is what all these higher scriptures are revealing. How to do that. And how to do that is, you don't need to do something to do that. You just need to be. You just need to be. Advaita Vedanta says again and again, non-duality says again and again, don't do, just be. Being, no doing. Just continue here. And by the time self realizes things, by the time the self realizes, things have gone too far, and then the weak and victim card starts to play. First it was mentioned that the mind holds on to something and makes the drama and wants to prove its existence, because mind wants to prove its existence, that it exists. So it will engage in the drama and grow so gigantically and consume the space that the self is covered completely. And then by the time the self realizes, the soul realizes that it has been covered and the game has gone too far, things have gone too far. By the time one becomes weak, and the victim card starts to play, then you say, oh my God, I'm weak. See, this is that space that I want to connect here and say, this while observing that the cloud is coming and it's taking over the drama, the mind is trying to prove itself and grow enormously. That is the click where the awareness should be. If the awareness is not there, the cloud will cover up. And then this will happen. By the time the self realizes, things have gone too far, and then one becomes weak and the victim card starts playing. Are you observing this? If you allow that action or inaction, whatever you call it there, whatever you're supposed to do, if you don't do it through that awareness, if that awareness shows you what is the right thing to do there, if that is not done, then it's too late. By the time it's too late. It's because self is so known and exposed to the mind and so not familiar with self that it falls for the mind to play its victim. It's very clear. In this game, actually, all other bodies around are used to play the drama whose writer is my mind. All the other bodies means other people around. They are also used to the play whose drama again, the drama writer is my mind, the script my mind writes, and that engages myself in the drama and involves the other people around me also into that drama. So it's like I am writing the script. Where is the script writer? Who's the I? The mind. The mind writes all the script. Very beautifully explained. Very, very beautifully. It's deep. So I thought I should read this. This not knowing is what I feel I am finding answer to. See, you are knowing it already. You are knowing this gap and everything you are knowing. But still, because you, while writing, this is the mind that is writing. This is not the awareness that, because awareness can never write. Awareness can never express. Awareness only knows. You know, awareness knows. Awareness doesn't know any other, it cannot have philosophize something or put a theory to something or put it into words. That's all the mind work. So you are relating it, yourself is studying this, but you made a note of this, the whole thing, but it's been done by the mind. So immediately you write, this not knowing is what I'm trying to find the answer. This not knowing, why you're not knowing is, because knowing is awareness. Once you're into awareness and you just watch, I mean, if you just watch your own mail in awareness, without reacting, without having an opinion, without a suggestion, advice, a judgment, nothing, you just watch it, you'll know. The knowing will be there. But the moment you try to put it into words, it becomes no more a knowing. it becomes a doing. So this not knowing is what I'm feeling. I feel I'm trying to find an answer. And you can find that answer just when you still and shift yourself into awareness. The knowing will happen. Because it's very simple. Everything is revealed here. You just have to now observe it. While writing this, I have tears in my eyes, enough to blur my vision. Confirming that what I am feeling and conveying is much needed at this time. See, that is the expression of that soul again. You know, once you're saying, you're writing down everything, you're expressing it. There is a knowing, but you're expressing it. But while you're expressing it, you are not in the knowing. And at that same time, you have tears in your eyes that is confirming. The soul is confirming that you know it already. So it's just a little slip here and there. I don't know if you can catch what I'm saying, but this is what I'm reading through. This, the tears, the overwhelming feeling of realize something. When do you have these tears? These are not the victim tears. This is definitely not the victim tears. This is the joyous tears, the blissful tear. Why does this tear come? Why does your eyes blush with the tears? While you're writing this, because you have realized it, that truth is being touched by your soul. So that is a confirmation that's coming through this. And you say, this is a confirmation. This confirmation is somehow a brief that I am on the right path. See, immediately after writing that, you say, this confirmation, the tears, is somehow a brief that I am on the right path. Yes, you are. The soul always takes you to the right path, and that is a confirmation that comes through that overwhelming, you know, response through tears or emotions. This is a blissful feeling, right? See, you say, this not knowing is what I'm trying to find an answer to, but slowly when you just come down, you're mentioning that, you know, tears coming in, and then you are confirmed that this is a confirmation that you are on the right path, and it's a blissful feeling. See, this feeling is the knowing. This feeling that I am on the right path is the knowing. You know, there is nothing to express here. There's nothing to say here. It's a knowing, that space. And that's the blissful state. You know, when you touch the space of knowing, there will be that confirmation. What is the confirmation? The bliss. When you touch the space, I'm on the right path. I'm there. The blissful feeling, that is the confirmation of that you are in the space of knowing. Communicating to the Supreme, I want to experience more than this bliss. See, that's a catch. You say this is a bliss. Yes, exactly. This bliss is not the supreme goal. It is to go even beyond this bliss, because these blissful experiences, temporary experiences, come and go, come and go, come and go. Sometimes it is a happy feeling, sometimes it's a nice feeling, sometimes it's a joyful feeling, sometimes it's blissful, sometimes it's ecstatic. These are all again changing. Anything that changes is not eternal. These are just glimpses of again transitory phases of your mind. So happiness will come, again it will go down also. That is why you are saying there is a deep need for that longing. That means it has gone down. And when you go up, when you have gone deep into that, and when you experience that, you have touched that. So can you see, it's a dual phase. Up and downs are going on, which is not true. So you have written it perfectly, pinpoint where you said, I want to experience more than this bliss. See, your soul knows that you got to even transcend this bliss. There is where the destination is. Want to experience Chidakasha, though I don't even know what and how it is. Now do you need to know? See, you want to experience the Chidakasha, but you know, you are saying you don't even know, but you know what I'm trying to tell you, because you said I want to experience more than this bliss, more than that bliss, transcending that is that space of Chidakasha. So nobody can define it. You know, when you go to define it, it's very difficult. Even if I go to define it, I cannot. But I know what you're talking about. All what you're mentioning, I can relate. My soul can relate to it. Because there is a knowing that this soul has touched that space again and again. So I know it's beyond words. When you are trying to put through words also, I am connecting the dots and saying, yes, that is the same thing that you are looking forward to, which I am seeing. See, this is what I am saying. When I am trying to relate to something which I cannot speak, and I am trying to relate again and again through so many multiple dramas, and somebody is catching that. Yeah, I see. That's it. That's it. Forget all these things. Forget all these talks. Forget all the videos. Forget all these dramas. You're getting it. That's what I want to convey. Bless me with Viveka to do whatever, wherever it is needed, till this is completely known and experienced. You need not have anybody's blessings in this. We are all blessed. Mark my words. We are all blessed. Never go with the feeling, bless me. Never go with the feeling that, give me more. Or make me, no. You are already complete. That is what in today's morning's message also, I put that video, check on my Jake Light profile. Tattvamasi, thou art that. You are already in that situation, but there are other things that are coming and distracting you. So you feel you are not Tattvamasi. And then you feel it is somewhere outside there, so you got to do this, that, to go and attain that. It's not that way. You already know. These are the hints for all that. You know what you're saying. These are the hints for all that. So there is nobody to give you Viveka from outside. And you know, whatever and whenever needed, till this is completely known, your soul will guide you. This is what is said. The master, when your master converts within, this is what happens. First the external master comes. I don't know which path you are in, but first the external master comes and then puts you onto that path where you are enlightening yourself, and then the same master converts into the inner voice, the inner self. The self is the master. See, it is always said, when the disciple is ready, the master appears. When the student is ready, the master appears. It is always taken in the outside terms, terminology. No, if you go in the higher relative terms, It is when, who is the student here? Your mind, your ego is the student. The you, the false you, is the student always. That is trying to learn and grow. Who is the perfected one? Your higher self. It is perfect. It is in a perfect state. Tattvamasi, which I am trying to say, is that is already in a perfect state. So you are in this dual personality right now. You are more in the other personality, which is the false I. All, when this false I goes off, you are automatically in the higher self. You are that self. You are that soul. That is what all these scriptures are trying to say. So when the student is ready, the master appears, means when the ego and mind is ready now, after having all the falls and all the sufferings, and after learning too much and saying, now I'm ready. The ego or the mind says, now I'm ready. I need to evolve beyond this egoness. That is the time that student, that ego, that mind is now ready to prepare. As soon as the mind is now ready from within, the master appears. The soul is there to guide it. It appears and it begins guiding it. The light of the soul begins guiding it. And that is the relationship. External, there is this guru-shishya relationship. But when it converts into, after a certain stage, it will convert within. And then your journey begins inside. The master, yourself only, has projected and manifested outside as a master. It's the same soul. It's that same self. So when that is realized, that is not true. Anything that is changing, anything that is physical, anything that can go off, is not true. There is something else. That is the consciousness. That, where is the consciousness? It's one consciousness. Same consciousness. It has come out from that self only. That man. So that, then you, the mind starts relating to the soul. This is after a certain stage it will happen. It has to happen. Till then it will be outside, outward. The full readiness is not yet there. It is still, the learning is there from outside. It is needed to go within. So once one starts going within, then this disciple-master relationship begins, and the soul becomes the guiding force. The soul takes to the final destination, which has been confirmed by all the scriptures which I can read out, how the soul and the mind are working together for that. So when you say, bless me with Viveka, there is no one outside to bless you with anything. Just turn that same thought or feeling inward. You just look at your soul, which is your master within, and say, bless me with more of power of discrimination and my intellect. Because that's your master is, where is your master? Residing within, in the Chidakasha, the space of Chidakasha. So you are actually looking to the abode of the master, which is Chidakasha, and saying, give me this clarity in my Viveka, discriminate, so that I can now discriminate more and more of what is real and what is false. The outside world and in my inward world also. And that light of that Chidakasha, that space, will illumine your life, and that will illumine your Viveka, and that will take you up. So that will be your guiding force. Now you have projected it out, but what I am trying to say is the same thing you projected within. So the voice of Nityananda, what you are hearing, maybe you are hearing from outside, that is because your direction is outside. You turn that within, and the same Nityananda, the Parabrahma from the Chidakasha, the same Nityananda will speak to you from within. Are you getting it? Hope this helps. I don't know if it will make, this video will make sense to many, but even if a few people catch this, even if 4 or 5 people catch this, I'm telling you, you have touched your essence. You have touched the core, and you'll know what to do next. Keep walking. Much divine love and light to you. Stay blessed.